In this video, we are going to see what is a latent covariate and how it can be used to model parameters with mixtures of distributions. In this project from the demos, a simple PK model has been fitted to the observations. A binary categorical covariate called group is available. That could be the sex or a genotype, for example. In the diagnostic plot, I can see that the volume is correlated with group. And in the tab result, the result of the statistical test confirms that this correlation is significant. This suggests to add group as a covariate on the parameter V. Indeed, when looking at the plot of the observed data colored by group, we can see that it seems to have an effect on the kinetics. In the plot distributions of the individual parameters, I can split the histograms in subplots according to the modalities of group. The empirical distributions for Ka and Cl are quite similar to the theoretical distributions for both modalities of group, but the empirical distribution of V are quite different. This shows that the distribution of V for the whole population can be seen as a mixture of these two distributions for the two parts of the population. Including the covariate group in the individual model for V defines this mixture of distributions in the statistical model. The two subpopulations corresponding to the modalities of group have two different typical values. Vpop for the reference group, where group equals 0, and Vpop times exponential beta V group 1 for the modality 1. After estimating the parameters on this project, the theoretical distribution for V now reflects the mixture of distributions, and when splitting by group, the empirical distribution in each group corresponds well to its theoretical distribution. Now, what if the information on the group were not available? This is where latent covariates are useful. The purpose of a latent covariate is to be able to use an underlying categorical covariate that we assume exists but is unknown. Then, this unknown covariate is treated as random variables, and the probabilities of each modality are part of the statistical model and should be estimated as well. On this example, there are two modalities, 1 and 2. After the estimation, for each individual, the categorical covariate is not perfectly known, only the probabilities of each modality are estimated. So latent covariates can be useful to model statistical mixtures of populations, but they provide no biological interpretation for the cause of the heterogeneity in the population, since they do not come from the dataset. I am now going to show how to define in monoliths the distribution of V as a mixture of distributions with a latent categorical covariate. Let's have a look at the same project with no covariate. In the statistical test, there are results of Shapiro-Wilk test that check that the transformed individual parameters are normally distributed. Here we can see that the p-value associated with log of V is quite high, so the test is barely significant. This suggests that the log normal distribution on the whole population for V is misspecified. To check this, I will have a look at the distributions of the random effects displayed as histograms. The empirical distribution for eta V seems to show some heterogeneity. Although it is not very clear, it seems from this bump here in the distribution that there might be different groups of random effects for V. We can choose to assume that the population consists of several homogeneous subpopulations, and we can try to model this distribution as a mixture of several distributions. This can be done in the covariate part by clicking on Mixture. A pop-up window opens to define a new latent covariate. I will leave the default name LCAT and choose two modalities. The latent covariate LCAT now appears in the covariate part. I can include it in the individual model of V by clicking on this box, like any observed covariate, and I can check in the formula that the model now includes a parameter beta to estimate. When running the population parameter estimation, we notice that in addition to the new parameter beta V LCAT 2, two new parameters are also estimated, called PLCAT1 and PLCAT2. These parameters are the probability of each individual to belong to each group. They can also be seen as the proportion of individuals in each modality defined by LCAT. Monolix takes care of all the estimation process for these parameters, so it is not possible to change their initial values or to fix them. In that case, I can see on this plot and also in the results that the probability for the modality 1 is 0.343 and the probability for the modality 2 is 0.657. The sum of these two estimates is 1. Once the population parameters are estimated, the latent covariates corresponding to the most probable group to which each subject belongs are estimated together with the individual parameters. These values are available in the results files. For example, in the last column of the file estimated individual parameters. Or along with each individual probability in a dedicated file named latent covariates. The estimated individual values for the latent covariate L4 can then be used as a stratification variable. For example, the VPC for each group can be displayed by splitting by L4. The theoretical distribution for V now takes into account the mixture of distribution with the mixture law. I can also split this plot to visualize the distribution for each modality. Finally, notice that latent covariates can also be used for non-continuous data, for example to model populations of responders and non-responders visible in survival data.